What up, 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 world? It's your boy Amp Dog with another episode of Politicking. I want to thank everybody for tuning in, showing your love. And today, make sure you tell a friend, tell a mother friend, Big Amp Dog said, what's the deal? Today, we're going to talk about Mr. Bill Cosby. His conviction has been overturned and he will be released. I guess they said within hours. The Pennsylvania Supreme Court just ruled that there were two reasons, not one, but two reasons why they should, why the conviction could not stand. the judge allowed prosecutors to call five other accusers during the trial, and Cosby should have never been criminally prosecuted based on an agreement he made with the DA as far as doing a deposition, and anything that he said would not be used to file criminal charges against him. and as for that reason, the Pennsylvania High Court ruled it was unduly prejudicial to allow five women with similar stories to Andrea Constand to testify. They were trying to show, they were basically, with the five women that they were bringing in, they were trying to show that Bill Cosby basically he had an MO for drugging and sexually assaulting women after he got them high. That's the reason why everybody gave him that nickname, Pill Cosby. but I mean, I don't know. I don't condone anything like that from, you know, if this is, well, he said it in a deposition. It shouldn't have been used against him, but he did say that he used to put Quaaludes, you know what I'm saying? And we're starting to see a trend with certain people that think it's okay, you know, like the whole Charlamagne thing. You know, this guy, he's just a disgusting person. You know, even drugged your own wife. But anyway, the second reason was fought hard during trial. The former DA, Bruce Castor, cut a deal with Cosby that if he testified in a civil deposition, he would not face criminal charges. Cosby did make incriminating statements about drugging women and that was presented in the trial, which then the Supreme ruled that at that point, the deal was broken by the prosecutors. The judge vacated both the convictions and the sentences and ordered that 83-year-old Bill Cosby be released immediately. Okay, so they not only told him that he was a free man, but he cannot be retried. Cosby has served 3 years out of the 10. I think, you know, just what last month, they refused to give him, what is it called, parole. They refused to give him parole because he refused to follow any of the sexual abuse programs that they have for if you get convicted for doing sexual assault or something like that, you got to do these programs, and basically he refused to do it. I seen the mugshot that they put out, I guess, you know, when he was going back and forth to court. He had a smile on his face. I think Bill Cosby knew exactly what was going to happen eventually. It's kind of crazy because when you hear something about what happened last May, you know, I mean, May, last month, and him, you know, refusing to do that, and then they tried to basically use that against him, like, we're not going to release you, and then all of a sudden Supreme Court comes in and they basically show that you guys were doing, you know, it was a greaseball way to go after a person, you know what I'm saying? And reality is, let's say if he really is guilty, right, let's say he really did do these things to this particular female, the DA just caused, y'all just all messed it up. The whole prosecution team, y'all all messed it up, you know. But I can't lie. I can't sit there and act like I'm not, you know, low-key happy for him, because a lot of the stuff that was happening, the timing that it was happening, it was just like what we see every day now, even more magnified. It was just an attack on, you know, a successful, prominent black person. And then, you know, they try to strip him down. And so I always felt like it was an ulterior motive that came with this whole putting him in jail and things like that, you know, just the whole grease ball, slime ball way that they went about it, you know. So, yeah, free Bill. I hope he don't come out trying to get the judging people because they ain't wearing their pants baggy no more. They wearing tight ass leggings now. So these men are dressing different now. So you can't be talking about pull up your pants and all that shit. You know. Plus, you part of the real nigga squad now. Only a bunch of real niggas been in prison. You know what I'm saying? And, you know what I mean? Nigga, you did not snitch. You know what I'm saying? Hey, anyway, y'all drop y'all comments and thoughts down below. Tell me if y'all think I'm tripping. Tell me if y'all agree. Is it free Bill or free pill? Which one is you riding with? Like, share, subscribe. Tell a friend to tell a friend. Big Amp Dog said, what's the deal? And...